الحسين على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد الرسول رب العالمين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وعملا متقبلا يا أرحم الراحمين. Oh Allah, teach us what benefit us. Increase us in knowledge, in good morals, and in good deeds, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we thank Him for blessing us to have the day of Friday, which is the greatest day, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned in the authentic ahadith, where he says, this is the day in which Adam was created. Sayyiduna Adam alayhi salam was created on this day. And on this day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave him. So this is a blessed day for us. It's like the weekly Eid. I'm glad that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us to come and to listen to the reminder, the obligatory reminder that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made as an obligation on every Muslim male. Sisters are forgiven from this, are exempted from this obligation. But of course they are encouraged to come and learn about their religion always, especially in this time and in this place, in this country. We, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessings, are still commenting on Surah Al-Fatiha, the greatest surah. And we talked about Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about Himself, that He is Ar-Rahman, He is Ar-Rahim, He taught us to praise Him. He praised Himself, teaching us to praise Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praise and thanks are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one who deserves all praise and all thanks. And He mentioned Rabbil Alameen. Rabbil Alameen means He's the one who takes care of them, who raises them up, who legislated many legislations so that He will help them reach their perfection, their kamal, as Imam Ibn Ashur radiyallahu anhu mentions, in their spirit and in their bodies. And that is what tarbiyah and rabb from. Rabb from tarbiyah, the one who raises you up until you reach your perfection, or you reach a great status in your body and in your spirit. And this is what your parents do, right? And this is why we call tarbiyatul abna, raising the kids. Raising the kids in Arabic, tarbiyah. This is where the word Rabb comes from, right? The Rabb is the one who raises you up, right? Your parents takes care of your body in general. And that is very important, and that is their responsibility. But what is more important is that they raise up your spirit, your soul, so that you will be saved on the day of judgment, so that you don't attain just a temporary happiness with some clothing and some food and some... No. So that you attain the eternal happiness, the happiness of paradise. And this is why, when he said Alhamdulillah Rabb, the one who raises up, he said Rabbil Alameen means the Lord of everything. Al-Alameen, everything besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's Al-Alameen, plural of Alam. So He is the Lord and the Rabb of the worlds, all the worlds, everything. وَهُوَ رَبُّ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ, as He says subhanahu wa ta'ala in the last page of Surah Al-A'raf. وَهُوَ رَبُّ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ, He is the Rabb of everything. Humans, animals, angels, everything. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he says, Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. He's saying, Imam Ibn Ashur, one of the greatest Muslim commentators on the Quran, he said, those marbubun, those people, and the creatures in general, they are weak. And this is why they need mercy. They need mercy. They aspire to mercy from this Rabb, from this Lord. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them and mentioned that description, that He's Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. And what description? SubhanAllah. He did not say Rahim, which is enough to say merciful, Rahim. No, he said Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, two qualities. He described Himself subhanahu wa ta'ala with two qualities that show the comprehensiveness of His mercy, the consistency of His mercy. That He is always merciful and comprehensively merciful, amazingly merciful and compassionate and loving and caring, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we spoke about this before. Now, he said, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, he said, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. He's saying the word Rabb in itself, it carries that meaning of love and mercy and care. Then why he said Ar-Rahman? The word Rububiyyah, the word Rabb in itself, it carries the meanings of mercy. When we say this person is the Rabb or Murabbi, means he takes care of you, he helps you in everything you need until you reach your maturity. See how the parents, subhanAllah, take care of their kids. And look at their love and mercy. Despite the so much tiredness they give them. Before, since they are in their womb, right? You know, the nausea the women feel, the tiredness, as Allah says, حَمَلَتْهُ كُرْهَا وَوَضَعَتْهُ كُرْهَا. In their pregnancy, they have some difficulty, and when they give birth, they have some difficulty as well. SubhanAllah. And this is why when they give birth, their sins are forgiven if they show patience and gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And despite all these difficulties, once they have their baby on their chest, they smile and they started thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then you know how much time at night they don't, with all the pain they have, they don't make, we did not make our mother sleep, right? Despite all this, they take care of us. Look how, subhanAllah, bit by bit, second by second, keep looking at us, looking after us. We pollute for them in the house every day. They clean us. They take care of us, everything. You see the mercy they have? SubhanAllah, we cannot never compare Allah's attributes to any human being or any creature. Allah laysa kamithlihi shay. He is incomparable to anything. But look, just reflect on the parents, particularly the mother. The mother has a greater right. And this is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was asked about the person who deserves the best companionship, what did he say to the companion? What did he say? Who knows? What did he say to him? He said, your mother. He asked him, then what? Then who? He said, your mother. Then who? Your mother. Three times. Then he said, your father, right? The mother has a greater right. And this is a reminder for myself and my respected brothers and sisters to take care of your mothers. Take care of your mothers and fathers. Take care of your mothers and fathers, right? SubhanAllah. Even I look at my wife when she's breastfeeding, and you see my kid, he pulls her hair and he gives her even pain in every moment, subhanAllah. She's nourishing, she's giving, she's showing mercy, and still he's pulling her hair, and she's sleeping, he climbs on her. She did not sleep all night, and still he wakes up early, mashallah. He slept enough, so he starts jumping on her and he wants to wake her up. Still, she shows mercy, right? She shows mercy. He pollutes here and there, and she cleans him here and there, and still she shows mercy, keeps showing mercy. So that is called murabbiyah. See, murabbiyah. She is raising him up. So the word rububiyah or murabbi in itself, does it have mercy or not? It has mercy. Yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after he said he is Rabb al-Alameen, he said He is also Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. And what that means, Imam Ibn Ashur is saying, you might raise someone up, but in a harsh way. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing you that He is not any Rabb. He is Rabb al-Alamin and He is Rahman and Rahim. He is helping you to reach your maturity or your perfection or a greater status in your spirit and in your body in a merciful way, in a loving way, in a caring way. He did not make difficulty in religion. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is raising every kind in the way that suits it, whether an animal or a human being or a plant or any creature. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that rububiyyah is a great ni'mah, a great blessing, but even that blessing that sometimes could be applied by harshness. Some parents, they raise their kids with harshness, with beating, which is not good and never recommended, right? And has very negative effects. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows you His mercy and His tarbiyah with so much mercy, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at these great blessings, countless blessings that He has favored us with. Look at these great rulings of Islam that are full of mercy. If you're a traveler, they say the traveler has seven permittance in Islam. He doesn't have to pray the four rak'at as four. He can make them two. He can combine the prayers in most of the schools. He doesn't have to fast. He doesn't have to pray Eid. He doesn't have to pray Jum'ah, etc., etc. So much mercy to all people. Someone cannot pray while he's standing. Okay, you can sit down. You cannot pray while you're sitting. You can pray while you're lying down. You don't have water. You just use any soil. Subhanallah. So this tarbiyah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is enveloped with mercy in all of its aspects, not only to humans, but to every creature. Subhanallah. We can talk about this more and more. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-An'am, كتب ربكم على نفسه الرحمة. Your Lord, look at this, subhanallah. Here we're talking Alhamdulillah, Rabb al-Alameen. Then he said what? Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. He is Rabb, and this Rabb has what? Rahman, Rahma. Comprehensive Rahma. Continuous, persistent Rahma. And look at this ayah in Surah Al-An'am, same thing. He says, كتب ربكم, your Rabb. كتب means what? He has prescribed on Himself. Means He made it as an obligation on Himself. He Himself made it as an obligation on Himself. What? To do what? To show mercy. كتب ربكم على نفسه what? الرحمة. As Imam Ibn Kathir, he says, أوجبها على نفسه الكريمة تفضلا منه وامتنانا وإحسانا. That He has prescribed it in His glorified self out of His grace and mercy and love. Out of His grace and mercy and benevolence, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to show that this mercy is comprehensive, it is a mercy with the believers and also mercy with the hypocrite, with the disobedient ones, with the rebellious servants of Allah, by showing them, by giving them time to repent and giving them time to return to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Another reason the scholars, they mention, these are just reflections on the Quran to show you that every word in the Quran has a reason and a purpose. There is no repetition for no reason at all. Every word, every letter in its place. But sometimes we know, sometimes we don't. So some of the scholars, they also say, when the Arabs, they hear the word Rabb, it comes to them the meanings of those masters who were cruel, who were harsh. You know how they used to treat slaves, right? So maybe some of the Arabs will fear this word, the word Rabb. Right away Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling them, I'm not like any Rabb. I am Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the word Ar-Rahman is not only in this world. is very comprehensive. It encompasses this world and the next world as well. As our beloved said, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and we commented on this before, that he put in this world one portion of the mercy and kept 99 for the hereafter. Allahu Akbar. And this is why our beloved said, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in Sahih Bukhari, if the disbeliever knows of the mercy that Allah has, he will never despair of paradise. If the disbeliever knows the mercy that Allah has, he will never despair of paradise, of entering paradise. And if the believer, listen at the other side, and listen at the balance that we have in Islam. If the believer knows the punishment that Allah has, the punishment that Allah prepared for those who rebel against him, then he will not feel safe of the fire, of the hellfire. That is the balance that we should have, dear brothers and sisters. We have so much hope in Allah's mercy, and at the same time, we fear his punishment. And this is why we have to work so that we are entitled for that mercy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned very clearly in the Holy Quran, who will get that mercy? Who will get his mercy? I'll give you just one example. Just one example from this, from the Holy Quran, Surah At-Tawbah, chapter 9, ayah 71 and 72. He said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ. The believers, men and women, they support one another. Listen at their characteristics. Listen, if you want the mercy of Allah, these are some of the qualities that entitle you to Allah's mercy. It's not by, as some Muslims, they say, as we say in Arabic, they do as-sab'a wa dhimmatuha, and they say Allah ghafur rahim. They do the seven major sins and maybe 70, and then they say, come on, Allah is most forgiving, most merciful, and they don't plan to repent, and they don't quit, and they don't... No, it's not by wishfulness. It's not by just words. You need to act and work and do what Allah wants you to do to show that you truly want to get that mercy. He's saying, subhanahu wa ta'ala, they support one another. They enjoin what is good. They enjoin what is good. Many Muslims these days, they are either shy or embarrassed to enjoin what is good. They see someone, mashallah, is putting his wife's picture on Facebook without a hijab, without anything, and making her like just a show for everybody. And he comments, mashallah, mashallah, beautiful picture. Mashallah, brother, you will get a sin by that comment. That is a sin. And instead of privately messaging him and telling him, brother, that is not how a Muslim behaves. That is not permissible. And instead of giving him a piece of advice, you comment and you like his picture or his photo, and you comment and encourage him. Subhanallah. Oh, no, I don't like to offend him. Subhanallah. These excuses made us lose the privilege that made us the best community that has been raised for humankind, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. When he said that we have been the best community raised for humankind, the first thing he said, after believing in Allah, that you enjoin what is good and forbid what is evil. Now, because we feel shy, we are afraid we'll offend them, subhanAllah, then we quit enjoining what is good and forbidding what is evil. On the other hand, or on the contrary, sometimes we're encouraging a brother holding his cigarette and mashallah showing on Facebook, or his argile or shisha or whatever, all these harmful things, and he's putting himself on Facebook and everywhere, mashallah. Subhanallah, if you have been afflicted with a test or a sin, you should cover yourself. And for us as believers who love one another and who support one another, we should help one another and give advice to one another. And not click likes, and mashallah, brother, you look amazing. Mashallah, astaghfirullah, how he looks amazing while he's doing the sin. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they enjoin what is good and forbid what is evil, and they establish the prayer. they maintain their prayers and they give their zakah and they obey Allah and His Messenger, then Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ سَيَرْحَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ. Those are the ones that Allah will show mercy to. Those are the ones who are entitled to Allah's mercy. أُولَٰئِكَ سَيَرْحَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. Then Allah says, in the next ayah, that Allah promised the believers, men and women, gardens under which the rivers flow, abiding there forever. Then he says, and the pleasure from Allah is even greater. That is the great success. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who apply those characteristics so that they are entitled to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. In one of the dua, Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our beloved Prophet, he taught Sayyidina Mu'adh, he taught him a very nice dua. I'm quoting this dua to show you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Rahman in this world and the next world. And He is Rahim in this world and in the next world. His mercy encompasses everything subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course, His mercy for the believers cannot be compared to His mercy to the unbelievers. But He has mercy for all subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this world and in the next world. In different types, different ways. He said to him, Ya Mu'adh, O Mu'adh, shall I teach you a dua? If you have debt, even like the Mount of Uhud, Allah will help you fulfill it. Anyone who is indebted, who has debt, here's an amazing treasure from your beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, you say, Allahumma malika al-mulk. Oh Allah, you are the owner of all sovereignty and dominion and kingdom. تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء وتعز من تشاء وتذل من تشاء. You give sovereignty and kingdom to whomever you wills, and you take it away from whomever you wills. You honor whomever you wills. You put down whomever you wills. بيدك الخير. You control all good. Surely you are able to do everything. رحمن الدنيا والآخرة ورحيمهما. You are the most merciful of this world and the hereafter, and the most compassionate. You give them to whomever you will, the mercy and the dunya and the akhirah. You give them to whomever you will and deprive whomever you will. Irhamni, have mercy on me. Rahmatan tughnini biha ar-rahmati man siwak. Have mercy on me with which I don't need anyone else's mercy. Irhamni rahmatan tughnini biha ar-rahmati man siwak. Have mercy on me that suffices me from anyone else's mercy. Allahumma arhamna bi rahmatik ya arhamar rahimin. Rahmatan tughnina biha ar-rahmati man siwa. Yes, everybody will get mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what is the mercy? What is the mercy that will truly benefit you and save you? It is the mercy of being saved from the hellfire. I'll finish with one ayah, inshallah, next time, if Allah wills, I will bring the other ayah, which is more amazing, but I finish with this ayah to prove this point. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Surah Al-An'am, chapter 6, ayah 16 and 15, قُلْ إِنِّي أَخَافُ إِنْ عَصَيْتُ رَبِّي عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. Say to them, I'm afraid if I disobey my Lord, I'm afraid of a painful torment, of a great day. مَنْ يُصْرَفْ عَنْهُ يَوْمَئِذٍ فَقَدْ رَحِمَهُ. Whoever is saved from that torment, then he has truly received the mercy. وَذَٰلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْمُبِينَ. And that is the manifest success. So the ultimate mercy, dear brothers and sisters, that we need to aspire to and look for and work for is that mercy. To be saved from the hellfire, from the torment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admit us into paradise without any prior reckoning or prior punishment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our parents and our loved ones. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to fulfill the qualities of the believers who will be entitled to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.